guys. Welcome back to Strong Successful Male, and a happy belated New Year's to you all. Hope you guys had a great time over the holidays. I definitely did. I just got back from being away on vacation for 2 weeks, and even though I definitely had a good time, it is certainly good to be back. So for today, I'm going to go over an email that was sent from a subscriber. This is from a guy. He is in his, I believe, late 20s now, and he's going to share his story about something I'm sure a lot of you guys can relate to in one way or another. He shares his story about his experience in college, how he back then was more of a blue pill guy, if you will. Definitely a lot of those traits and qualities that didn't help him very much in certain relationships. And, you know, I gotta tell you guys, there probably isn't one of you guys watching this right now that didn't do some of the things that I talk about in the videos when you were younger and didn't know any better. Okay, I was one of them. I made plenty of mistakes. And by making those mistakes, I learned. And now I can help you guys out by reading the stories and the articles, pointing these things out to help you guys not go through the same BS that I went through as well as many of you guys did. But this guy here, no different, but he learned. And you're going to see here through the story, this guy back a few years ago in college got involved with a woman who became a hardcore effinist a couple years into their relationship. They already had differences go early on. He was more of a conservative and she was more of a liberal. But at the time it was more of a playful, if you will, playful, you know, differences on things. But then things in the world changed, and I'm sure you probably can connect the dots as I start reading this, where she overnight went from being one way to being hardcore. And let's just say it completely destroyed what they had initially as a pretty fun relationship. Okay, went to hell in a handbasket. But this guy, as you're going to see here, sticks around, puts up with her crap, which a guy should never do. Makes a lot of mistakes, which he acknowledges. But eventually you're going to see, guys, he'll get out of this and get on, and his life is now doing really well. He's learned a lot and so forth. It's a good story to hear from, but it's important for me to read this for you guys to see the mistakes he makes, especially for you relationship types of guys, because let's be honest, most of you guys watching me are relationship guys, whether you want to admit it or not. Lot to learn from this one. So he starts off, he says, "Hi, SSM. I found your channel a few months ago, and I love your content. I was already kind of stumbling blindly down this path of getting RP'd in life, gotta speak in code, until I found your channel and other similar ones. I hope you keep up the great work and continue to inspire young men and those women that are watching, who may be struggling that need some guidance and direction. Bro, this is my purpose. I love what I do. To be honest with you, I couldn't wait to get back here and get started after being away for 2 weeks. And thank you for your support." He says, "I'd never been completely blue-pilled guy, but for most of my life, I would sometimes express some blue-pill moments as I didn't know any better at the time. Like I said, dude, we were all there one form or another." There's very few guys that start off in life with the kind of knowledge that a lot of us have learned the hard way, or being a little more badass, if you will. We all were brainwashed by movies and TV and the music and obviously our environment to act a certain way. And then when it backfired, it took some of us a lot longer to figure things out, how things really are. So don't worry about it. "I want to share my story from my college girlfriend to my current one with you to let all your viewers know that there is hope of finding a good woman out there who does have a good moral principles and values." He says in parentheses, "I live in California, so it's damn hard to find them out here." Dude, I can imagine. And I say this quite often, I'm fair here. There are some good ones out there, but sadly, they've become more and more rare thanks to brainwashing by the effinist movement, amongst many other things, and other things that have definitely screwed people up, like social media and things like that. They're there, it's just rare. To find a girl with traditional, old-fashioned values, actually has some good principles and things like that, unfortunately, it's rare. But he found one, you'll see. So, for some background context, I live in a suburb of the capital, California, Sacramento, and I ended up a few years ago working and saving money going to junior college and transferring to another school. Even though I jumped into school in the middle of the program, I made friends quickly. I'm outgoing, and I've never had problems making friends wherever I go, especially with women. Dude, that is a very good quality to have. Guys, if you have the ability that wherever you go, that as long as there's people that speak your same language and you can just chat people up and make friends pretty easily, that's a great skill. Okay, a lot of people don't have that. I'll be honest with you guys, I have that ability You put me anywhere. If I'm in a good mood, I can chat up anybody, have a conversation, and make friends. It's just at 44 years old now, I've gotten to the point that just, I know so many people are just, let's be honest, a-holes and have bad manners and are pain in the ass, so I just tend to keep to myself. Occasionally, I'll be in a good mood. I'll start chit-chatting people in line at the grocery store or when I'm at the airport or something, but a lot of times, I just keep to myself. But it is a good quality to have, guys, and a good thing to practice because it will help you in life. Anyhow, about a year and a half after I moved to my new school, my then partner, Lauren, partner, you mean your girlfriend? This is some California political correctness in you coming out here. Girlfriend. My girlfriend, Lauren, and I had a mutual split in which we both agreed that the long distance relationship was no longer working, and we were both fine with that. He says, we are still friends to this day. Immediately after that, like that day, a girl I had started developing feelings for, Jamie, who also had feelings for me, and I didn't realize that, had sex with me because I just became available again. So you broke up with your girlfriend a little the same day, some chick you liked, you were hooking up. And while I can say, cool, dude, you gotta relax, you gotta take it easy, give yourself a rest before you go jumping into something else. You're gonna see, guys, this guy is a serial relationship guy. Or at least he was. He says, to be clear, I never cheated emotionally or physically, as that is a despicable thing to do. I just kind of had a mild attraction to her that had developed over the previous months as my then current relationship was deteriorating, but I kept that to myself. I believe you, man. It's okay. You can window shop. You guys can be in relationships if that's what you do, and you can have a gal you find attractive, but it's a different ballgame if you're actually, you know, hooking up with her and you're still with your girlfriend. That is not cool. I don't advocate cheating in any way. If your relationship is going to hell in a handbasket, or you just lost interest, break up with the girl. You know, don't be like these gals out there that I tell you I read stories about who cheat on their guy, had the old have my cake and eat it too situation, milk him for everything it's worth, but stop cheating with Chad and Tyrone. Okay, you don't want to be like them. Okay, we want to be higher up over here. That night after I told Jamie I ended things with Lauren for good, she told me she had feelings for me and we got to business. Little did I know that was the start of another 5-year relationship. Serial monogamist. On to the main story. Now, Jamie, by the way, is the one who you're going to see is going to become a hardcore nut job effinist. I let Jamie know that I didn't want anything serious, as literally I just ended a 5-year relationship and she was fine with it. That is for about 6 months prior. Let me start over here. Literally just got to have a 5-year relationship, and she was fine with that. As about 6 months prior, she just ended a 2-year one, so she understood. Well, she was probably attracted to you more when you said pretty much, hey, I don't want to rush into anything, you know, and you're taking your time. She's probably thinking, oh, challenge. I'll get this guy to commit. He says, however, once we crossed that bridge of intimacy, there was no going back. We smashed like rabbits. My apartment was about a 3-minute walk off campus, so when we weren't in the same class together, we had the same major, we'd be at my house during the day and get it on whenever anyone else wasn't there. Because my place was so close, several of our friends would root in and out during the day for an hour or two between classes, so they didn't have to walk all the way back to their house or sit in the student union. That was a pretty fun period of time. College was fun. Although, I'd never want to go back to high school. Not a chance in hell. College I could do for a few months for fun. That was a good time. Jamie and I debated many things like religion and politics, as she was more left-leaning and I was more right-leaning. Here's where the trouble begins. She was 22 and I was 24, and this was back in 2015 before everything went crazy. So these differences in values, morals, and what we wanted out of life seemed pretty inconsequential at the time, but boy, it would really wreak havoc later. So yeah, you're a conservative, or more conservative, and she's a liberal. Now, I like everybody as long as they're not rude or disrespectful and a-hole about things. I got friends that are liberals, and I'm definitely different views on things, but the ones I know can keep it in a respectful, you know, level. But in terms of relationships, guys, okay, this isn't the relationship channel, but I've been in enough of them to tell you, to be able to know some things, to point things out to you guys that are. Opposites attract, okay? Don't get me wrong. It's the opposites that makes things interesting and draws them together, polarity. However, there are certain things that it's not a very good idea to be opposites in, particularly politics and religion. And that could definitely go to hell in a handbasket quick, depending on how things are in the world. And you're going to see here, and I'm sure he said this is in 2015. We all know it started in America in 2016. When I read this the first time, I was like, oh shit, I know where this is going. But yes, being different in terms of personality traits and stuff like that, that's okay in opposites attract. But major things like politics and religion, it's not going to go well. He says here, we both went home for the summer. She lived about an hour and a half away, and we spent many weekends together when I wasn't working two summer jobs. We moved into a house with all of our friends, five of us total, and it was pretty fun. I always insisted on having my own room, and I would not share my room with Jamie at the time because I wanted to be able to have my own space. Very smart. Although I wouldn't recommend moving with your girlfriend. I know you're in a big house with a bunch of friends and all that, but still, I would not be in the same place with your girl. But, you know, you can't change the past. But at least you had the sense to have your own room. Good. Very good. That was a pretty uneventful but fun last summer of my college career. Not much to say about it other than that everyone else had more to complete before graduating in the spring. However, that was also the November election of Donald Trump, which plays a key role in what transpired over the next few years. Yep, I knew this was coming. And I can only, and I'm sure you guys can imagine when he said, again, he was more of a conservative and she's more of a liberal and things going to hell in a handbasket, wreaking havoc. Because of so much squawking in the media, Jamie went hard effinous with all the joyful little things that come along with that. She had always been a little into that whole ideology, but Trump was the thing that tipped her fully over the edge. I'm sure there isn't one guy watching this that didn't know some girl, or some people, if you will, who really was, they weren't into politics that much, but the second that dude became president, all of a sudden they had CNN or MSNBC on all the time. They started going to marches and protests and things like that, and they couldn't shut the hell up about politics. I mean, just never ending. I've known some women like that were obviously more laid back, and then they become obsessed with it. It's like, shut the fuck up, okay? Go back to being the cool, fun person that you were before. Because it's one thing to be aware of things, but to become obsessed. And so many people, particularly women, became nut. And this was all fueled by the media. And it wasn't any better on social media. That's one of the reasons I deactivated my Facebook account. Because it was just all people ever talked about. Politics, 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 and expressing their views and their feelings online. It's like, grow the fuck up. Grown-ass adults acting like children, having temper tantrums and all that. It's okay. You can have your own views on things. That's fine. But when you can't shut the hell up about it. So this is what this guy went through, and it completely just destroyed his relationship. Or should I say, she destroyed the relationship. It says here, we've been openly dating for a while at this point, and her behavior shifted over the next 2 years until it reached a point I could no longer handle this. You put up with her shit for 2 years? There you go about the whole blue pill thing. Because I guarantee the man you are now would have tolerated what you guys are going to see for a minute. She openly would talk about her disdain for all men, calling every single one stupid, and began to act like she was God's gift to the earth. SEX had basically completely dried up at this point. Showing my blue pill ways at this point, I would still try to do things to get her to change her behavior back to how things used to be, but it was a lost cause. I would constantly go out of my way to do acts of kindness for her to show her how I cared. But she acted like she was just getting me, getting me in her presence was the greatest gift she could bestow upon me. So let's review. They went from hooking up all the time, like rabbits, like you described, to pretty much nothing. There's a big surprise. Debating her disdain for all men, saying that all men are stupid. This guy should have gotten the hell out of there the second that started, because what's the point? They're not having any fun together. They're debating. She's hating all guys, pretty much saying he's stupid. No more SEX. It's not a romantic relationship. It's just a toxic relationship full of turmoil. There's no romance going on here. But unfortunately, because he had a couple great years in, and this guy's a good guy, and obviously he was blue pilled. Oh, I can fix her. I can get her to go back to be the old her. No. And by the way, a lot of this was already inside of her. But world events just unleashed it. Not a good situation. Guys, if even if you had a good thing going for a couple of years for your relationship, guys, if all of a sudden a girl you're involved with changes like this, complete 180, for whatever the reason, whatever the cause, get out of there. Life is too short. Don't waste your time. You're not going to change them. Let her be someone else's problem. But a guy sticks around and puts up with all this shit, she's not going to respect you because nobody, especially women, nobody wants to be around a pussy. Okay? And guys that allow shit like this to be disrespected and treated this way are seen as pussies. It is what it is. Anyhow, we both have been out of college for about 2 years now. Still seeing each other on every weekend. He says, ugh, long distance again. And I've been trying to convince her that we need to live in the same city, but I would just get BS answers and dismissed over and over about it. So you're chasing after her, okay? You're pursuing the relationship, and she's pursuing this very warped, effed up purpose of hers of, you know, taking down the patriarchy and men and all that. That's her purpose. But you're being the relationship guy. You're in the you've taken the role as the woman, trying to work on the relationship. And chasing after her. It's never a good idea when the guy is chasing after the girl and trying to be the one making the relationship the purpose. It doesn't go well. It says here, we argued endlessly about this and our opposing values on pretty much all topics. Why didn't you get out of there? It's not worth it. It was exhausting and draining and really sucked, but I was not going to back down on my value system to a social justice warrior who actually holds petty, pretty regressive views, which end up hurting lots of people, even though they are convinced they are always right. These types always think they're right. Good luck trying to debate and argue with someone like this. It's like the saying, I never argue with a drunk or a fool. There you go. But like an idiot, I kept thinking I could make this work. I could fix this. Oh, how naive I was back then. You were, but you know what? I respect you for admitting this and sending me your story, because yeah, you're going to get some heat in the comments section, but you're helping dudes out. And we were all like this, well, most of us, when we were younger. We didn't know any better. This is how we learn, guys, by screwing up and gaining life experience and hopefully and sharing our information, sharing our stories to help other guys learn. So don't beat yourself up. But again, back to this, I can make this work. I can fix this. That's usually the female mindset in relationships. One night, I've been thinking about all these issues that we were constantly arguing about and how no views we shared about anything came anywhere close to being aligned. Be it religion, and he says, I'm a Christian, she's not. Anything politically, she turned hardcore woke, and he says, I'm very much anti-woke, and the way we want to raise our kids, etc. Dude, it's bad enough you're with this woman when she's gotten to this point, but the fact that you were even considering having a future with her and children... If you think your life was a nightmare at that point, can you imagine having kids with this girl, being married to her? Your life would be a nightmare. To me, I could see this would only end in pain and misery, with divorce and payments if it continued, unless, of course, I was to be neutered completely and subservient to her, which was not going to happen. I'd rather die alone than be a sub to some social justice radical effinist. Amen, brother. You think your life was bad? At that point, can you imagine you got married to her? Oh my God. And she ain't going back to the girl she once was. If that's who she really... As if this person that after 2 years who came about wasn't there all along. He says, it had taken me way too long to come to this conclusion, but I decided that was it. In one split second, I decided I had enough. I called her up and ended things for her for good. Hallelujah. Took you 2 years, but okay, I'm glad you got the point. Looking back now, there were two great years in college where we were carefree and nothing really mattered. And then the next 2 years, she turned to a woke effinist, and I tried to make it work like an idiot because life started getting serious as we started getting older, and suddenly different views like on raising children really actually mattered. Imagine that. Yeah, it's easier when you're in college and carefree and all that, but then when you start growing up, becoming an adult, working, all that, and that's when you start taking these things more seriously. But remember I told you in the beginning, you know, opposites attract, but it depends on what the opposites are. But when it comes to something like politics and religion, this is something for you relationship guys. You want to see eye to eye with your girl. You know, you don't have to be 100 in terms of political views. Like, you can have somebody that can be, you know, you're pretty aligned. You may have a few minor disagreements, but if you're polar opposites on politics, it's not going to work. And honestly, if religion is really important to you, if you are a Christian and the other person is something completely on the opposite end of things, or let's just say you're very religious and you stick to certain conservative views and the gal you're with is the exact polar opposite, again, it's going to have some issues, especially if you think one day you want to get married and have kids, which I don't recommend, but if you're going to do it anyway, it's not going to be good. You want to be on the same page or pretty close to it. He says, at 27 years old, life was starting to get real now. As much as it sucked to end things at the time, in my defense, ending a 4+ year relationship is never fun regardless of the circumstances. However, I wish I did it years earlier. Hindsight's 20/20. So I dropped her, and all the grief and issues with everything else you get with your long-term girlfriend turns out to be a woke effinist. I'm sure it wasn't easy because you kept thinking about the past, but your present with her was miserable. So that was a great thing you got rid of her. And you know what? I'm sure she's either alone. In fact, I'd be willing to bet a lot of money on that she's alone and angry and probably chopped your hair and her remaining hair is now blue or green. She's probably 50 pounds heavier and walking around pissed off at the world wearing combat boots or something like that and going to these marches. And you have moved on. He says, what happened after? After a few months of casual dating, I found my current partner. Girlfriend. Smack. I'm going to smack that California political correctness out of you. Girlfriend. Since getting a little older, getting some perspective, and really thinking about what I want and in a partner, girlfriend, I was not going to actually start a relationship. If I was going to get into one, it was going to be with someone with the exact same value system as myself and who wants the same thing in life as I do. Good. You learn from your mistake. I was not going to date someone unless they met my exact criteria, because if I was going to get into another relationship, this one is going to be very intentionally done with the best chance of success possible. Very smart. Find someone that you have similar things. You know, it's not what you like, it's what you like. So you want to definitely, you can be opposites in personality traits, that's fine, you know. But on the main things, like I said, politics and religion, it's good to be on the same page. And also, in terms of what you want out of life, you know. My current partner, smack, girlfriend, Jessica, and I have been together for over two and a half years now. She is a girl who has more or less traditional values, except she likes to go to work and not stay at home all day. And she grew up in a very loving household with a fantastic mother and father. So her role models were her parents and really showed her what a great family dynamic and relationship should be like. You certainly are a relationship guy. Now you're on to another one for 2.5 years. But obviously, this is a girl that you click with and has the things you want. So cool. And notice he said here, she has a great relationship with her family. That's one of the biggest signs, guys, for you relationship guys. If your girl with her family, you go to visit her family, you see that it's a very good situation. The mom and dad actually love each other, and there's a lot of love, and there's a good thing with the siblings and all that. That's a good sign that your future with her can work. Okay, it's tough in this world, but it's a sign it can work, because she grew up in a loving household, so that's how probably her approach to relationships are going to be. On the other hand, if you went to her house and it was all this turmoil and drama, and mom and dad are fighting, and the kids and the siblings are fighting, and there's all this drama and bad communication, all this shit, guess what? That's probably going to be your future with her when things don't go too well. I'm not saying 100%, but that's probably how it will be. So you don't, if you see a situation like that with your girl, probably best to part ways at that point. He says, and that is what we strive for in our relationship, because my parents were also fantastic examples of what a couple should be and do for each other. She wants me to be the leader for her of the house, and she has zero intention ever pretending to want to be the leader in our household. Good. That's how it should be. your former relationship with your old effinist girlfriend, she wanted to run the relationship. Look how well that worked out. Your girlfriend's old-fashioned. She's traditional, wants you to be the leader. And as long as you are the leader, and I don't mean in some, you know, asshole kind of way, just take charge and let her follow the lead, you're going to have a good thing going because that's what she wants. But if you started going back to ways you were with your old girlfriend, it would turn your current girlfriend off. Just remember that. She says it sounds like too much work and would rather have someone make the important decisions, and she will support those, but with some input maybe in some important areas. This is, however, an exception with decorating, and that's fine with me. I don't want to deal with that, and the house has never looked any better. It's been such a win-win for both of us. Okay, there you go. That's fair. You'll be the leader in the relationship. You take charge. But if she wants to, you want to leave decorating the place to, up to her, fine. I would just say, just don't touch my man cave. And by the way, you're living with your girl. I've done some videos about that, but we can't change that. I'm not surprised you're living with your girl because you're a relationship type of guy. I'll have comments about that later at the end. He says, also, what's so important to me was if I was to date again, she would have to be someone who knows how to say, I'm sorry, you're right, without pulling teeth. Crazy, I know, to think there are women out there who willingly say that and to date. Yeah, I guarantee his ex would never apologize for anything, would never admit she was wrong, and would be like pulling teeth. He says, and to date, I never had to drag an apology out of her. When she is wrong, she will readily admit as I do. Good. That's healthy. Neither of us are too prideful for the other person, unlike my ex, and we cherish all the time we get to spend together as our interests basically overlap from what we do as hobbies and fun activities. Cool. Again, it's not what you're like, it's what you like. So it's good you have things in common and views. This can work, my friend. Just, I'm saying it can. I'm not saying 100%, which I'll get to at the end. We split rent and bills equally, which is nice, and our arrangement is that I keep up with the yard work and she keeps the house and kitchen clean, which has been working great. Of course, if there's a particularly large project inside the house or outside in the yard, we both pitch in and help the other person out completely, complete that task because we want to be there for them and you, and you know, let me go back here, because we want to be there for them and you know, you, your partner will help you back when you need it, and that's a great feeling to have. Cool. For the first time, it really feels like I'm in a solid, reliable team, which I know I can count on, and I'm not dating an opponent, which is a wonderful feeling. If you begin to feel like you're dating an opponent, it's not just a friendly game. End it. Being on a team where you both make sacrifices for each other instead of keeping score is so much better in every possible way. Right. The situation you had before with your freaking ex-hardcore woke effinist girlfriend, it was like a competition and keeping score and all that, because that's what they do, you know? Well, I called you last time, or I texted you last time. Now you need to text me. Or you picked where we're going to eat last time, so I'm going to pick the next place, keeping score. That sounds like a lot of fun, not to mention all the debating about politics. I bet with this guy's current girlfriend, they never talk about politics. And if they do, they're on the same page, and that's a nice place to be. He goes, jumping into a different part of the relationship, unlike my ex who rode the carousel before I knew her, racking up around 20 bodies or so. Dude, she told you about 20 bodies or so, but I guarantee your ex had way more than that. And notice he said his ex was a carousel rider, but then she became a hardcore effinist. Imagine that. My current girl actually never did that. She'd always stated that she wanted to wait for the right person. I kind of believed her, but after a few months of dating, she said she wanted to have sex for the first time. And I knew she wasn't lying when the proverbial fruit went pop. Holy shit, you got yourself a virgin. Now that is rare. This, however, by no means means she's vanilla. Doing that for the first time apparently awoke some sort of beast within her. She's down anytime, anywhere, and loves kinky and rough stuff, very easily outclassing any of more experienced girls that I've ever been with, and she's doing so enthusiastically. Well, that sounds awesome, bro. I am very happy for you, and I want you to enjoy every moment of that. But I want to point something out. The reason she's so down for anytime, anywhere, and giving you whatever you want is because she respects you, and she sees you as a leader, as an alpha. So you're doing things right, so good for you. But mark my words, if you start going back to your old beta blue pill ways, I guarantee the freakiness in the bedroom is going to come to a screeching halt. So keep doing what you're doing right now, being the leader and all that, and you'll keep having the fun. Yes, you're going to have moments it's going to slow down, but I'll come to that later, but good for you. After 2+ years of dating, I think I only have been turned down 3 or so times by her, and we still have adult playtime 6 to 7 days a week, implementing all sorts of fun things. Sometimes we both wake up at 3 o'clock in the morning and get it on, then go back to sleep and get up at 6 a.m. for work. But that's not as often as we made jokes to each other about having what feels like a dead bedroom, because that's not happening several times a week, in addition to the normal routine 6 to 7 times. Ha ha. Good for you, man. I'm happy for you. On a different note, what is funny is I've heard her state on many occasion times of RP beliefs of her own about female human nature, many of them being the same things as you say here in this channel. One time I asked myself, I wonder where she got these ideas, thinking somehow she found a YouTube channel like SSM, and when I asked her, she said nowhere specifically. And she came to these conclusions all on her own after watching her friends and basically taking a critical lens to their behavior and of others that she sees. And interesting that she was talking about things that I talk about in this channel and other channels like me. So I could see how you were thinking that maybe she was watching other YouTube channels. Or she was looking at your phone or your computer's browsing history and found me on there. But if she obviously sees these things and makes these observations, how things are so screwed up out there, that says a lot about her. He says, I know you talk about marriage and how it's a mistake and people shouldn't do it, but it really seems like this one is worth taking a shot with. I have never met someone I'm so in alignment with about literally everything. Marriage, family, how the household should be run, raising kids, values, morals, hobbies, activities, etc. I just want to put that out there. For any guys who are trying to figure out if they should keep on in a relationship and thinking about that, they are not any good girls out there. They are out there, but you won't find them on social media. One of the big vetting cues for me, and there was no way in heck I was going to date a girl obsessed with social media and their online image and profile. Yes, that is a key. New relationship, guys, if you haven't figured this out already, if you're dating a girl and she's obsessed with her Instagram or TikTok or Facebook, wherever the hell it is, and constantly needing to get this constant flow of attention and validation from dudes all over the world, no. Get out of there. It's not going to go well, because that's not going to stop. She's still going to keep showing pictures of herself online, getting all the likes and the comments and no doubt DMs from dudes all over the world. Okay? You don't need that. You want a girl who your validation and attention is enough. Okay? That does it for her. She doesn't need it elsewhere from dudes she's never even met all over the world. Okay? And there are so many gals out there are like this nowadays. Good luck finding it, but you want one that doesn't give a crap about that. He found one, so that's really good. But, my friend here, you need to still pay attention for the red flags. Don't go blind. Always keep your eyes open. I'm sure you've learned that already, but I got to mention that. No matter how cool she is, no matter how good your situation is, always pay attention to the red flags, okay? He says Jessica has social media, but she hasn't posted on Instagram in 5 years and only very occasionally posts family type of photos on Facebook. I would say to the guys out there, the less they are into social media, the better. Absolutely. I got a Facebook 1.5 years ago. I'm not going back. Couldn't stand all the drama. My Instagram, I think the last time I posted on my personal Instagram account was at least two years ago. So there you go. Good luck, gents, and thank you, SSM, for taking the time to read my story. I really do feel blessed to have met what is the most incredible, traditional, valued woman, and that somehow I did in California. Hopefully for the rest of you out there looking, she wasn't the last. Well, bro, that's a good story, and I thank you for sharing it. You definitely messed up when you were younger, but we all did too. But I want to address a couple things here. Two things. Number one, stop saying partner. I can't let that go. Girlfriend, take that California upbringing of political correctness and throw it out the window, okay? No, girlfriend. Drive me fucking crazy. Keep saying partner. Anyhow, number two. Okay, since you're obviously a relationship guy and you're going to go marry this girl regardless, okay, I just want to give you some information here to help you out, to make sure this works, okay? Like I said, You guys have a lot in common. That's awesome. Okay, you both said that she said she's traditional. She's the value. She's feminine. She wants you to be the lead in the relationship. Old school. That's awesome. You found yourself a unicorn and a one who likes to, who when you started, when you got together, was a virgin, and you wanted to, and she likes to hook up all the time and do all sorts of freaky, kinky shit in the bedroom. Cool. You got it made. The reason you're getting this is because you have embraced your alpha side. You're being the leader. Okay. You learn, you in your previous relationship with that nut job effinist, you saw what it was like when you're not the leader. Okay. So you're the leader in this relationship. So you're doing things right. Good for you. Keep doing that. Okay. Don't deviate from this. Don't get lazy and complacent and figure I don't have to act this way anymore and she'll still be there for me. Because if you stop acting like this, guaranteed, mark my words, break this shit down, dude, she's going to change. She's going to not be as cool as you think. Okay, as long as you're the leader and you take charge in a kind way, not being a jerk about it, things will continue on as well. But keep doing that through your relationship. And if you do get married, keep that up as well. And like I'm saying here, I don't recommend marriage in today's world, but you got yourself a good one. Good for you. I'm really happy for you. Seriously. But you have to pay attention to the red flags. Keep being the leader in the relationship. Now, if you're going to get married, you said you've been together for 2.5 years and you're living together. Okay, you're getting to see what she's like living together. And if after 2.5 years or whatever it is, you're still living together and things are still good, that's a pretty good sign. But still, I would stay in a relationship for at least another couple more years if you're going to get married. Okay, you can be in a relationship forever, honestly, bro. Because a lot of times people get married, they can have a great thing beforehand, but the second that ring's on her finger, that's when she can change. I'm going to hope she is not that type. I really hope that's not the case with you. Because you said she's traditional. She's you're see eye to eye in politics and religion. She wants the same things. Good family life. These are good signs that you have hope. But I still want things to go well for you. So wait another couple years before you take the plunge and get married. Okay? Really see what she's like in all situations. What life can hit you. Because again, until you experience all these different things and see what she's really like, you're not going to 100% know. Okay, I want you to talk to her about her goals in life. I'm sure you have already, and see that you're eye to eye on things. One big area is money. Is she someone that likes to spend a lot and racks up the credit cards, and you're a guy that's a saver? That's a problem. Make sure you're eye to eye on money, on spending things, on spending money, on saving, investing. These are very important things, okay? Because if you're polar opposites, that's going to cause you problems down the road. Financial issues is one of the biggest things that destroys marriages. So really make sure you're eye to eye on that. Another important thing, communication. Make sure you guys can communicate. There's a problem, and it sounds like it is good because you said that she'll apologize when she's in the wrong. That's a big deal. Good. Make sure you're both good at communicating. That you, if you're a good communicator and she doesn't like to communicate, or she's passive aggressive or some bullshit like that, that's a problem. But if you both can express what you're upset about and talk things over and listen to one another, that will really help you out. That is another area which sends a marriage to hell in a handbasket: bad communication. Another area that sends things to hell in a handbasket could be obviously sex. But if you both like to F like rabbits, okay, you're good there. But again, that is contingent that you keep being the leader in the relationship. That is a key. That's what she finds attractive about you. So keep being that leader. And there's plenty of other things, but those are the main areas. But just keep doing that. Keep having fun. Keep taking her out. Don't get lazy and think that, oh, I got this girl, so I don't have to take her out anymore. Wrong. You still got to keep treating her like you did. You get married or get more serious in your relationship, you got to keep treating her like you did in the beginning. Taking her out, picking the place to go, being the leader, taking charge, all that. Keep doing that, you should be good. And also, fitness. Keep yourself in shape. Don't. If you're going to get married, if you're an active guy and you keep yourself healthy, which you should. If all of a sudden you were fit and active before and you start getting lazy and putting on 25 pounds after you say I do, bad idea. Uh-uh. Because then she'll start letting herself go. Keep taking care of yourself. So, bro, you do all these things I recommend here, you definitely got a shot. But definitely, like I said, pay attention to the red flags. Don't ever stop looking for the red flags, because when guys stop looking for that, that's when things can get bad. Like, keep an eye. I know you don't want to have to snoop on your girl, but just pay attention. But anyhow, good for you. I'm glad that you got out of that horrible relationship. You learned a lot. Things happen for a reason, in my opinion. You go through some bad shit, guys. If you learn from it, then, That will help you, okay? It's not always a bad situation if you learn from it. But this guy's sharing a story, and now this long, holy shit, we're almost up to 40-minute video here. This will definitely help some guys out. So good for you. Thank you for sharing your story. And I'm glad you got rid of that crazy effinist. She's out there making somebody else miserable. Or she's just alone being even more miserable. So you had the last laugh. Good for you. All right, guys. That is it for today. Be sure to comment down below. Let me just think about this. And be sure to like the video, share it with your friends, and subscribe. And I'll catch you next time.